The St. Regis Parish family gathers to celebrate the Mass of All Souls. Please stand. Watchers and ye holy ones, bright seraphs, cherubim and thrones, raise the glad strains, Alleluia! Cry out dominions, princedoms, powers, virtues, archangels, angel choirs, Alleluia! Alleluia!
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, as we gather together this evening to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we do come to pray for all souls. And in a very particular way, at this Mass, we carry on the wonderful custom that this parish, like many parishes, does at the beginning of the month of November. We pray in a special way for those whom we've lost over the last year. It's an opportunity for us to carry out our duty as Christians to pray for our brothers and sisters who have gone before us, and for us who gather the loved ones of those whom we've buried in this past year. It's a chance for us to go forward in Christian hope and to gather and support one another in the love of this Eucharist. So as we prepare ourselves for this celebration, let us call to mind our sins and ask our merciful God for pardon and peace. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, life of all that is mortal and joy of the saints, we humbly pray to you for your servants, our loved ones, that freed from the bonds of mortality, they may possess your kingdom in everlasting glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in a furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd. Nothing can I want. He gives me rest in green pastures, leads me by quiet waters. He revives my spirit and guides me in right paths for his name's sake. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Though I walk through valleys of darkness, I fear no evil. You and staff to protect me. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Surely your goodness and mercy follow me all my life. Now and forever. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus arrived in Bethany, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. Now Bethany was near Jerusalem, only about 2 miles away. Many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him, but Mary sat at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise." And Martha said to him, "I know that he will rise in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this?" "Yes, Lord," she said to him. "I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Not too long ago, I ran across a quote from A.A. Milne, who was an English poet and writer. We probably best known as the writer of Winnie the Pooh, but he wrote a lot of other things besides Winnie the Pooh. And he once wrote, "How lucky I am to have something that makes saying goodbye so hard. How lucky I am to have something that makes saying goodbye so hard." We have all been blessed with that luck because we have had to, in a very hard way, say goodbye to people that we love. And ever since I ran across that quote, I think about it often because, you know, even though I've not lost anybody in the last year, any close loved ones, as we all do, we lose loved ones in the course of life. I think about my grandparents who died when I was a kid. And I think about my dad who died 10 years ago this past summer. I think about friends and other loved ones that I've lost over the years. I think about your loved ones too. Some I got to know a little bit more than others. I've not been in Trafford still all that long, less than a year and a half. And with all of those relationships, when we have to say goodbye, even if it's only for a while, it's hard. But it's lucky that we had those relationships and that we had the years and the times that we did to share with those whom we loved. You may have heard me say, because I think I've used it in funeral homilies enough, our first vocation as Christians is to be people who love. And when we love one another, I guess I can say when we dare to love one another, we are taking a risk. We take a risk in life that love may not be returned. We take risk in life that love may be scorned. But we also take the risk that we might be separated by physical death. In the world's eyes, that seems final. But in the eyes of the Christian, it is not. Our readings tonight speak of hope. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. They are in peace. Our loved ones who we pray for in a very special way tonight all knew affliction in their own way. For some, our loved ones suffered for a long time with illness, sickness, the effects of age. For some, the afflictions came in other ways. But they all knew affliction. But as they passed from this life, as hard as it is for us to say goodbye to them, we take great comfort in those words of the Book of Wisdom. They are in peace. That is what our faith teaches us. Because we who love are fulfilling our lives as Christians. We are growing into the fullness of life. And Martha's encounter with Jesus in the gospel, we can all relate to that too. Because Martha's obviously a woman of faith. I know that he will rise, Lord, in the resurrection on the last day. I know he will rise. But even though she has faith, she is in tears. She is mourning because this brother who she loved has died. We struggle with that. I've encountered so many people over the years, in my own family too, that we almost feel guilty as Christians whenever we mourn when somebody dies, because we feel that's not believing enough. But that's not right. It is appropriate for us to mourn. But we need to be very clear about what it is that we are mourning. We're not mourning the one who has died. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They are in peace. No, what causes us tears is our separation from them, because we realize what we've lost. The relationship isn't ended, it's changed, and we have to deal with that distance that we have from them now. And that's hard. It was hard for Martha. If we continued reading that story from chapter 11 of John's gospel, we would even hear St. John tell us that as Jesus approached Lazarus' tomb, his friend, he cried. He mourned. That is what we do when we love. But we also, as we come together, affirm our faith. We do that whenever we gather at the funeral home, with family, when our friends come. You know, I've heard over the years people say, you know, Father, when I die, I don't want any visitation. I don't want anybody coming to look at me. We may have even heard that from somebody that we know. But when we come to the funeral home, we say we come for viewing. Really what we do is we come for visitation. We come to be together, to love and support one another in a time of pain. And that's what we should do. But we gather together, we pray together, we tell stories, we laugh, we cry, and we go forward. For many of us, that meant bringing the casket up the street here to St. Regis. For some of us, we did it at the funeral home, but wherever we gathered to pray in a funeral mass or any kind of funeral liturgy, it's where we pray for our beloved dead. It's where we pray for us. And it's where we are sustained in our faith as we make the last journey to our loved one's resting place. Not to say goodbye to them forever. It's hard to make that journey to the cemetery. But it's important that we do. And as we go forward, for some of us, it's been months and close to a year maybe since our loved one died. For some of us, that loss is more recent. But as we gather together as God's family, we continue that process of moving forward. There's no time that takes away the pain, and we still feel the loss of our loved ones very acutely. But we continue to go forward in faith. This opportunity that we do, this wonderful custom that we have during the month of November every year, we pray for all souls, those who were in need of our prayers, who were still on their way to the fullness of the kingdom. We pray for them, we remember them, and we continue ourselves. And maybe in some little way, it's my prayer and my hope every year that as we have this opportunity to go together or to come together, that something I say or something that we do, or maybe it's the simple gesture of lighting the candles that we're going to do in a few minutes, but something about this liturgy that we do helps us to heal. Not to forget our loved ones, so our lives are never quite the same, but to help make saying goodbye for a while a little bit easier. And maybe help us to grow in faith as well. That we can love a little bit more as we remember the love and the bonds of love that united us to those who have gone before us. That we can love a little bit more. That we can grow a little bit more. And we can look forward, hopefully, to the day that we see our loved ones again. Indeed, how lucky we are to have something, someone, that made saying goodbye so hard. And how joyful will be the reunion when we see them again. We have assembled here before the altar candles with your loved ones' names. I'm going to read those names in chronological order of the date of their passing since last All Souls Day. And as I call your loved one's name, invite you to come forward. Jordan will assist you with a light that you can light your loved one's candles. And so let us, as we read these names, our mothers, our fathers, our brothers, our sisters, our sons and daughters, our friends and neighbors, let us pray for them and ask for God to bring them to his kingdom. Coletta Ammon. Burton Lynn. Frank Dvorak. Brian Casper. Rose Marie Tadero. Dorothy Zahowski. Gerald Zeckley. Bernadette Dilo. Janet Zeckley. Kathleen Matvia. Eileen Perry. James Kreis. Lorraine Gay. Christine Kennedy. Marie Montgomery. Marianne Holshue. Dominic Ciarola. Julia Klein. Helen Caruso. Erwin Uherick. Pauline Ciccatello. Cora Clark. Bertha Chrysance. Patricia Morocco. Marlene Fabianic. Elvira Mercaldi. Just light one in the front row. Light one in the front row. Geneva Stumpf. Angeline Hickson. Loretta Vaquero. Jeffrey McClure Sr. Donna Owens. Mary Mihawk. Mary Lou Calanja. Della De Caesar. Dorothy Edwards. Patricia Mirabello. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. May they rest in peace. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Let us stand. My dear friends, let us join with one another in praying to God, not only for our departed brothers and sisters, but also for the church, for peace in the world, and for ourselves.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. That all who have received Christ and believe in Christ's promises may be granted life without end and light which no darkness can extinguish. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord, our God, may wipe away the tears from all faces and lift the burdens of suffering from all victims. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the bereaved of our parish family gathered here tonight may find consolation and strength in our shared belief in the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dying who await the coming of the Lord may be freed from fear and filled with faith in salvation and hope of sharing life eternal. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our beloved dead, whose names were read tonight and who shared in the Eucharistic feast on earth, may share in the heavenly feast of the Lord of hosts. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we hold deep in our hearts, which we now pause to add.
O God, creator and redeemer of all the faithful, grant to the souls of your departed servants release from all their sins. Hear our prayers for those we love. Forgive them the pardon they have always desired. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the choir of angels welcome you where Lazarus is poor no longer. May you have eternal rest. May you have eternal
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, in your kindness, the sacrificial offering we make for your departed servants, our loved ones, and for all who sleep in Christ, that set free from the bonds of death by this singular sacrifice, they may merit eternal life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty in salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For it is at your summons that we come to birth, by your will that we are governed, and at your command that we return on account of sin to that earth from which we came. And when you give the sign, we who have been redeemed by the death of your Son shall be raised up to the glory of his resurrection. So with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Let us kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, Jesus himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We
proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Regis and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession and your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servants, our loved ones, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who were united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To all of our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
Together, let us now pray for the coming of God's kingdom, as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God.
Let us kneel. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that You should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For the distribution of Holy Communion this evening, I'll start first with the center section. I'll come to the left side here. For those who are Catholic and are free to receive in section here and over here, I'll distribute. And then for those in section two over here, I'll step over onto this side to bring communion to you.
And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. And I will raise
you.
Let us pray. As we participate in the divine mysteries, we pray, Almighty God, that they may advance our salvation and bring pardon to the souls of your servants, for whom we implore your mercy, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, thank you all for being here this evening. Just about every parish that I've been in my 24 years as a priest, we've done a Mass like this, and it's always, it's a very sublime liturgy during the course of the year, but it's a wonderful opportunity for us to be together, to pray for one another, and to do the ongoing work of ministering to one another. I know I say to every family at the funeral, I've said to all of you, that you can be assured of the promise of my prayers, and I know many people in the parish community continue to pray for you, but also that in the time going forward, if there's anything that you need, please feel free to call upon us. I hope that never sounds trite or rehearsed, because I do mean it sincerely. Even after our loved ones are gone, sometimes it is after the funeral, as we try to go forward, that's maybe when we need an extra hand the most. So you can be assured of my continued prayers for all of you, for the repose of the souls of your loved ones, and know that the parish is here for anything that we can do as we continue to go forward. And let us all continue to pray for one another. Immediately following the blessing and dismissal, Jordan and I will process out. Then I'll come back up here to the front. All the candles... we had a little problem there with reading some of the names on the candles, but all of the candles have the names of our loved ones. If you would like to take your loved one's candle home, I'll come back up here and assist you with that to put out the candle so that you can take it home for use at home. All the candles that are still here, if you want to leave your loved one's candle here, that's fine too. But all the candles that are here will continue to burn here in the sanctuary throughout this coming week. As a reminder to our whole parish to continue to pray for our loved ones. But if you would like to take your candle home, I'll come back up here to the front and assist you with that before you leave this evening. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. And please respond to each invocation with a hearty and heartfelt amen. May the God of all consolation bless you. For in his unfathomable goodness he created the human race, and in the resurrection of his only begotten Son has given believers the hope of rising again.
Amen.
To us who are alive, may God grant pardon for our sins, and to the dead a place of light and peace.
Amen.
So we may all live happily forever with Christ, whom we believe truly rose from the dead.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God. and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun.